This is NJ, your host on this channel. In this video, we are going to have a customized or a comprehensive discussion on what kind of vibrations this upcoming year of 2022 is bringing for all the people who are the owner of a small scale business, mid-sized business, you work with your own skill, you are a skilled person. So what kind of vibrations next year is going to be bringing? That is something which is going to be the center of over this today's discussion. So friends, I have already made a couple of videos for this upcoming year's vibration. I made a couple of videos from the astrological perspective, customized to all the ascendants. I also made a video from the perspective of numerology as well. But in this video, we will exclusively and specifically focus only on all those scenarios and cases that, let's say, for example, you're working hard from past couple of months or even years, and you are just waiting for that chance to start something on your own. So how this next year's vibration is going to be conducive or supportive for all of that, that is something which is going to be the kind of a epicenter of over today's discussion. And friends, I always get inspired by this one quote given by this very famous motivational speaker Jim Rohn, that success is something which we attract by the person we become. So it becomes very important that astrology is not something that you're not putting efforts, you are just waiting for some lucky break. Only if you have been working hard and your life is completely in sync with the nature, with your planetary vibration. So what kind of signs you have to look forward to, because this video is going to be done on two bases. First, I'm going to give you the signs of commercial success, signs for, you know, success and more opportunities for all the small scale business or entrepreneur or freelance skilled person basis the transit. That is one sign. And the second sign is what kind of dashas you should be running in order to take the bull by the horns or to take the chance, be on that proactive mode rather than being on a back foot. So you got my point. We are going to have our discussion on two sections. First is going to be, I'm going to give you the idea of the positive signs which this year's vibration is creating in transit, and second is signs to look at in your own individual chart or in your dasha. So friends, to begin with, like the way I already mentioned this thing, that whenever we have to talk about anything to do with the universal vibrations, that we first get to know by what kind of universal vibrations are getting created in that year, that specific year. So if you will make a sum total of 2022, so first of all, there is an energy of triple two. Now, two is a number which is being owned or governed by the planet Moon, which is all about emotions, which is all about togetherness, which is all about harmony and cooperation, business partnership. So which in itself is a good sign that if you have some good idea, if you're looking forward to some sort of funding, some sort of partnership, so this year's vibration can create some positive results for you. The second thing is that if you're going to make a sum total of the energy of these triple two, 2 + 0 + 2 + 2, you're going to get the resulting number as the 6. Now 6 is a number which is being associated with the planet Venus, which has everything to do with the, you know, your home economics, your responsibilities towards your home, domestic responsibilities, family, and most importantly, 6 is considered as one of the most auspicious number in the science of numerology. Like the way we say 3, 6 and 9 are considered as very supporting numbers. Like if you are actually going to take chance, you have some dreams, some aspirations, and you lack the resources, you lack the courage, or you lack that initial thrust or impetus, so the energy or vibration of the number 6 can be seen as very supporting for all of that. So in terms of doing something which your heart craves for, in terms of doing something where you need the support and cooperation from other people, so this universal vibration energy of 6 can be seen as a very positive sign. So that is one aspect. The second aspect is that, friends, now like the way I was telling it to you, that when you have to look forward to The signs to see the success in business, any of your entrepreneurial success or your goals, aspirations, anything to do if you are a owner of a small scale business, you work with your own skill. So for all of those concerns in astrology, out of all the 12 zodiac signs, we always give attention to the air zodiac signs. Like the way many people say that fire signs should also be given more attention. But trust me friends, when we talk about in today's day and age where everything is governed by social media, digital marketing, your resourcefulness, your contacts, your followership. So because of that, air signs gain more predomination. So now when we talk about the air signs, so Gemini, Libra and Aquarius are the three air signs. Now friends, what is going to be happening this year is that now if you will first take the transit of the slow moving planets which are going to be transiting this year. So let's take up the case of first Rahu and Ketu. So as you know that Rahu and Ketu are currently transiting in the Taurus and the Scorpio axis. But on 13th April, Rahu and Ketu are going to change the signs and they are going to come into the sign of Aries and Libra. Now here I want to point out one thing that many people say that Rahu doesn't function very well in the fire signs. Like definitely many astrologers have attached and associated Rahu's exaltation sign as Gemini and some psychics take Taurus as Rahu's exaltation sign. But friends, when we talk about the innate nature of Rahu, Rahu wants to try new things. Rahu wants to do something out of the box. Rahu wants to explore the world. So all those exploration, doing things, initiating something, exploring something, experimenting with something, somehow all of those energy are associated with the Aries sign. In the original Kalpurush Kundli, Aries is the first zodiac sign. So the soul takes birth in the Aries, the first zodiac sign of the Kalpurush Kundli. So the point which I'm trying to make over here is that this can be seen as a very positive sign that let's say for example, the moment Rahu is going to enter the sign of Aries for initiating something, experimenting with something, trying to expand yourself, experimenting in different markets, in different venture, Rahu's energy can be seen as very supporting, can be seen as very conducive for that. Now let's take our discussion to the next outer planet. So for example, now if you will take up the case of Jupiter. So now friends, the beauty over here is that in transit as Jupiter, which is currently transiting in the Aquarius sign. So Jupiter is in the Aquarius sign definitely. And from the Aquarius sign, Aquarius is one of the air sign. From over here, Jupiter is going to be aspecting the Gemini sign as well. Jupiter is also going to be aspecting the Libra sign as well. So because of which friends, even in the transit, Jupiter, which in itself is a scene as the significator of new opportunities, new doors, new ventures, blessings from the divine. So Jupiter's presence in the Aquarius can be seen as a very good sign. And now friends, the moment Jupiter is going to enter the sign of Pisces on April 13th, even this placement can be seen as conducive in this regard that in order to start or initiating something new, you need to get rid of all those energies which have been coming in the way. So now whether in the form of gaining a upper edge on the mass psychology, anything to do with the how to manage your expenses well, explore the foreign unknown terrain, and along with that getting rid of all those things which have been worn out, which need to be get rid of. So Jupiter's presence in the Pisces can be seen as a very positive or supporting energy for all of that. And lastly friends, as you know that Saturn, which is currently transiting in the Capricorn sign, so Saturn is finally going to make an entry in the sign of Aquarius in January 2023. But the beauty over here is that in this year, briefly, Saturn is going to enter the sign of Aquarius. So in the month of April 2022, around April 29th, Saturn is going to briefly enter the sign of Aquarius. Until July 12th, it is going to be transiting in the sign of Aquarius. Now, which can be seen as a very good sign, friends, because from the past 18 months, 1.5 year, whatsoever Saturn has been making you do, whatsoever you have been enduring, you have been working hard, whatsoever struggle and hardship you have been facing, you can fairly see the result of that coming in play. And like the way, friends, whenever we talk about anything to do on a mass scale for seeing the signs of success in business, we always give attention to the placement of Mercury and Saturn in the chart, and we specifically look at the third house or the seventh house, the original air houses. So because of which, friends, even the Saturn's presence or Saturn's transit, this brief time when Saturn is going to be transiting in the Aquarius sign from April 29th till July 12th, that small window is going to give you this idea that are you actually working hard in the right direction if you have been looking forward to starting something on your own. So the result of that will briefly start coming in. The ultimate final result will only come when Saturn will finally make a foray in the Aquarius sign on January 2023. But this brief 3 months of Saturn's a brief stay in the Aquarius sign will definitely give you a hint that whatsoever hard work you have been doing, what kind of result ultimately will come out of those hardship. And lastly, friends, so these are some of the signs which I wanted to give you, the signs of hope, signs of optimism, that whether you are a owner of a small size business, you work with your own skill, or let's say, for example, you are on that stage of your life that you have been you have amassed or accumulated good corporate experience of 10 years 15 years, and now you want to start something on your own. So the energy in the universe or the universal vibration is very conducive, is very supporting for doing something, accomplishing something for which you are going to get that sort of contentment or for what your heart craves for. So these are the signs which in the universe, in the transit, planets are going to create. So that was one aspect of our today's discussion. Now the second aspect is that what are the dashas or what are the signs which need to be promising in your own individual chart to take the risk, to take the bull by the horns. So now we will take our discussion over there. So now, friends, like the way I always include numerology as well in all of my discussions, and I have already explained a couple of times how to calculate the personal year. That is very simple. All what you have to do is that take up your month of birth and your date of birth and add it with the universal year. So let's say, for example, if you are born on March 2nd, so March is number 3, 2nd plus 2, and the universal vibration of 2022 you will get the 6. So you have to add 3 plus 2 plus 6. That is going to give you the personal year vibration for you for the next year. So friends, I would say that if you are in the personal year vibration of either 1, of 9, of 3, or of 6, so that can be seen as a very good energy for not only inviting good opportunities, good sign up, new agreements, and along with that, getting into that mode of transition. So a transition can prove to be successful for you if you are in the vibration of the personal year, which I just mentioned, 1, 3, 6, or 9, can be seen as very positive from the signs or from the fields of numerology. Now we will come to the point of having a discussion from the astrological perspective. So definitely, friends, if you are running the time period of the planets, specifically the Mahadasha or the Antardasha of the dignified planet, that is the first requirement or eligibility. Second thing is that, let's say, for example, if you are running the Mahadasha or the Antardasha of Rahu, that can still be seen as very positive, very promising. I've already mentioned this thing that in transit, somehow Aquarius energy and Aries energy is going to be very strong next year. And Rahu is in the Aries sign, and Rahu has got the co-rulership of Aquarius. So I would say that if Rahu is next year activated in your dashas, that can be seen as a very promising sign. The second thing is that, friends, whenever we talk about either in the form of inviting, attracting new opportunity, or any transition, anything to do with starting your own business, starting your own venture, so definitely to begin with, we have to give attention to the air houses, which are the third house, seventh house, or the 11th house. The second thing is that we also have to give attention to the fifth house, because fifth house is 8th house from the 10th house, so which is the transition or transformation in your career, in your profession. So let's say, for example, friends, if you are running the Mahadasha of the Ascendant Lord, of the ninth house lord of the tenth house lord, and the Mahadasha lord of these house owner planets, which I just mentioned, either first house lord or tenth house lord or ninth house lord, they are well placed, they are dignified, or let's say for example they are dignified but they are placed either in the first house itself, tenth house itself, ninth house itself, giving strength and power to those houses, or if they are even sitting in the third house or the fifth house, that can be seen as a very positive energy, very positive sign that you can actually initiate something this year, and your ongoing planetary dasha and vibration is definitely going to work in sync with the universal vibration, and something concrete can be accomplished and achieved this year. So that is something, friends, which I just wanted to say as a part of my consolidated summary, that how this upcoming year's vibration is going to support, is going to kind of encourage all those people who are in that crossroad of their life, that they just want that spark to fulfill their dreams, to in order to take that first step. So that is something, friends, which I wanted to say as a part of my inputs. If you have your own suggestion or anything you want to add, or let's say for example you want me to make last, because we just have last few days left before this year is going to come to an end, so if you want me to make a consolidated sneak peek or a summary specific to any one profession, specific to any one area of life, in sync with the 2022 vibration, you can write your suggestions, your valuable inputs in the comment section of this video. So that is something, friends, which I wanted to say as a part of my inputs on this topic. For furthermore updates and notifications on the divine science of Vedic astrology, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and like my Facebook page. Dhanyavaad.